following pictures, taken at the risk of his life, were procured for curiosities by a member of the Marine Guard. The hideous voodoo ceremonies are held in secret and varied locations. The ceremony begins at sundown and continues all night, becoming wilder and wilder as the fanatical dancers work themselves into a religious frenzy. At midnight, the supreme sacrifice is made, during which a child of 3 or 4 years of age is killed and eaten. Children for the sacrifice are plentiful, because it is considered the greatest honor of voodooism to be chosen as the mother of a sacrificial victim to the serpent worshiper.
No, we're not crazy. No, we're not going in some backwoods sacrificing any babies or anything like that. No, we're not digging up any of your people's graves or any of that stuff. We are practicing a legitimate religion.
Well, the thing about voodoo, that thing, they can get a voodoo doll, like the voodoo doll here, and just stick pins in it. In Hollywood, they do that. In the movies, they do that to make money off of it. But voodoo is a religion.
Voodoo is feared because it is not part of the mainstream religions. And people tend to fear what they don't understand.
Birthplace of jazz, a city famous for spicy foods, majestic architecture, and colorful history. But part of that rich tradition is a faith among many New Orleanians in the power of charms and spells, gree-gree bags, and voodoo dolls.
We had a lady in our neighborhood, and she wore this rag around her head. And when these people would go there, most of them would leave with this little drawstring and this little bag hanging around their neck, you know. And this was to drive off evil spirits and bring good luck. So one day, we found one of those little white bags, you know. Inside was a rock, a piece of pine wood, and a chicken foot. Just one finger off the chicken foot.
So there was a lot of mojo bags going around, lucky hand bags going around. A lot of people with card games in their house who used, you know, something to try to keep the money in the house instead of some winner taking all the winnings out of the house. There was always someone who realized that the people who owned the house, owned the card game, were using something, so they'd need to use something to counteract that, so they'd be going into the game with a mojo hand, and the work just perpetuates itself. You see what I'm saying?
Hexes and good luck charms are deeply rooted in New Orleans culture, but they're only a small part of the local practice of voodoo, a religion brought over from the old country by the slaves.
The origins of the religion of voodoo are in Africa. The two main branches in the world of what we know today as voodoo are Dahomey, which is now the Republic of Benin, and southwestern Nigeria. And from Dahomey, we get the religion of voodoo, the manifestations of which are in Haiti and also in New Orleans. And from the Yoruba religion of Nigeria, we get religions like Santeria. We get Candomblé of Brazil, the Xangô Baptists of Trinidad, but the cosmology and the belief system in the voodoo and Yoruba are basically the same.
Voodoo is the evolution of African shamanism, which has been recreated in the Western world, mainly in Haiti. Voodoo is really a generic term for a number of metaphysical practices.
And voodoo literally means spirit, deity, and God, the creator of the universe. we believe in God, but under this God force, there are many spirits, forces, and deities that are called the voodoo gods and goddesses, the Loas, or the Orisha.
The natural forces which build the universe are earth, air, fire, and water. The deities are a personification of these four elements.
The voodoo gods, the Yoruba gods, are very, very much equated with the forces of nature. For example, I am a priestess of Oya in the Yoruba religion. And Oya is the goddess of the winds and the hurricanes, and she is the queen of the spirit world.
Main spirits would be Papa Legba, who's the intermediary between the metaphysical world and the physical world. You have Dambala, who is the spiritual solvent or the high spiritual deity of voodoo. You have Ogun, which is the spirit of war. And you have Baron Samedi, which is the spirit of the dead and magic.
The African concept of death is not finite like it can be in some terms of the West, because people in the West sometimes tend to view death as being a period, punctually, whereas Africans tend to view death as being a comma, you know, a brief respite and a continuation of the same thought on the other side.
And the African has, according to voodoo, has managed to master the spiritual plane in order to manipulate things on the physical plane. So in voodoo, the dead are not dead. There are living spirits without bodies, and that heaven and hell are not, heaven is not in the sky, hell is not on earth. It's right within the same dimension. So the reality is multidimensional.
People believe that they can pray to their ancestors, people who lived on the planet, who are of their bloodline, who share their same sympathies, and maybe working out the same familial karma. They believe that these people can intercede in behalf of them while they're still on the planet.
Voodoo is a way of life. Voodoo is the way of thinking. It's the way of behavior.
Prosperity in all you do. And for this to be affirmed, five times the sacred number of Oshun, Ashe.
The people that are practicing voodoo are not doing it on Sunday only. This is an everyday affair. This is waking up with the Loas or spirit forces, going to bed at night thinking about the Loas. This is honoring the Loas in every step of your life.
It's involved in becoming in tune with oneself, with that inner spirit, because each and every one of us are blessed with that inner spirit.
Though often dismissed as primitive superstition, the religious symbols of voodoo and its country cousin hoodoo have long been a lightning rod for fear and suspicion.
The skull, the snake, these are things people associate with voodoo, even the doll. And these all have legitimate symbolic reasons for being a part of the religious ceremonies of voodoo. But because people don't know what those meanings are, they place their own meanings on them. Well, in my religion, the snake is evil, so that means voodooists are evil. In my religion, skulls mean death, so the voodooists adore death. And then they throw the cross in there. How dare them? That's our symbol.
The crossroads. Here you have the sign of the crossroads, which is the cross. It is the domain of Ilegba, Papa Legba, who is the god of the crossroads. It is where heaven and earth meet. And so the symbol of the cross is very, very a powerful symbol in voodoo.
Then we've got the skull, another really scary looking symbol that you'll see in most rituals. It's not about the bones, it's about what it symbolizes. And the skull symbolizes the ancestors. And ancestral worship is a very, very important part of voodoo. This is the cycle of life.
The serpent represents the voodoo god Dumbala, who is all about wisdom. He's an ancient deity. The fear of voodoo is also perpetrated, say, by the creation myth in the Christian religion. The Adam and Eve story and the serpent doing the tempting of woman.
One of the things people get very confused about is the snake dance, which is done by normally a female. And that is just a physical representation of that spiritual balance between that masculine energy coming from the sky, the snake, and the woman symbolizing the earth. So that's where the snake comes in, you know, representing wisdom, light, energy, balance, all good stuff.
And when we think about trying to connect our thoughts to a ritual object of focus, no different than a Christian feels that their prayers are more powerful when they're looking at a cross. You know, that when we have an object to focus on, it's not the object itself, rather than what the object represents for us inside of our consciousness as human beings.
Fantastic legends surround the most famous symbol of New Orleans voodoo, the doll. But if one discards the myths invented to frighten children and entertain tourists, the African roots of local voodoo dolls are revealed.
We use doll in all of those items, but not especially dolls. But do we use doll also, but not specially.
What you have are some objects, some ritual objects, whereby the placing of nails or metal objects into them is a way to tap into some power.
There are a lot of things that are made to affect reality, and many of them are made for healing. You see figures that have been wrapped. You might even find someone's hair or fingernails. You may find other kinds of parts of animals or herbs that have to do with healing what the particular problem is.
It is not to be construed as something that you're trying to wreak vengeance or harm or havoc upon someone. But by the time it gets to New Orleans and it gets mixed with European superstition, European witchcraft, then these little dolls, which had to be constructed to distinguish them from the ritual objects in Africa where they came from, then there's this notion of mixing this with magic and then being able to hurt someone.
This doll here is made, I put it on my altar and I blessed it. I put a spirit in this doll, a real live spirit into this doll. This doll can be for anyone, but before I give it to them, I hold their hand and I say a prayer. And that way, the doll is for that person to own it. When I was born, God gave me a gift to heal and to help people, you know, and so if I misuse it, use it for bad things, I lose it. God will take it away from me.
There are people who call me all the time because they want negative things done. And I tell them, under no circumstances, for any amount of money, will I do anything negative. Because you do reap what you sow. You cannot do an evil work or invoke an evil spirit to hurt someone and attempt to build a circle of protection around yourself. I would be rich if I were to cater to the demands of people who want evil work.
I think people are impressed by acts of power. To be able to strike out at someone without physically touching them. We're fascinated by those kind of things as human beings, and it's more dramatic. It's not long, quick, drawn out work. This is quick, fast, hurry.